It is always great to be back in Philadelphia, and it is particularly always great to be back at Annenberg. I mean, I will never say no to an invitation to come back here. This is where I cut my teeth. This is home, and it's always great to come back home, and always great to know that I'm welcome back at the Annenberg School. The one thing that we can and should be keeping with all the different modalities of our writing is method. What did you do to get to your results? If there's one word that immediately comes to mind about my 4 years, slightly under 4 years that I spent at Annenberg, was intense. I'm not sure, at the time, I think I held the record for the fastest PhD completion at Annenberg, which was like 3 years and 9 months. My earliest memories were, again, finding my pocket of humans that I could latch onto to get me through this PhD program. So my work now focuses entirely on broadband and broadband policy. I just published a book in September 2021 called Farm Fresh, Broadband, the Politics of Rural Connectivity. And it's all about the question of why rural communities don't have access to the internet. What are some of the policy failures? Average people need to care because average people are frustrated that they don't have access to the internet, or if they do, it's super expensive, or that their internet access is spotty. I mean, something around the lines of 30% of this country does not access the internet at broadband speeds. Tens of millions of Americans lack access to the internet, and they are frustrated, and we're hearing that they're frustrated. The United Nations said that internet access during the pandemic was a matter of life and death. There are no bigger consequences than that. And I think, you know, one of the takeaways from this awful pandemic has been the importance of affordable, high-speed, high-performance broadband. In the early 2000s, I was a senior-level figure skater for Canada, competed at four different Canadian championships, and even qualified for the 2006 Olympic qualifier. I didn't actually end up competing, I retired before then. I often say that if there's one thing, you know, figure skating taught you is you fall in front of 20,000 people, you learn how to get up. And if you can do that in front of 20,000 people, you can stand in front of a classroom of 300 and teach. So I've never needed to kind of psych myself up for teaching. It's never been kind of anxiety provoking because it's a performance, just like figure skating is. I put on an outfit. In the case of figure skating, I'm performing, you know, triple Lutzes. In the case of teaching, I'm performing about broadband policy. I think I'm in the point in my career where I'm looking towards not just, you know, what's my next book, but what am I doing in this field? And I'm really excited for an opportunity to hopefully do some field shaping, right? And to take a step back and ask, like, what are the big questions that us in critical communication policy studies need to be tackling? That's really where I'm going to be turning my attention to in the next 5-10 years is thinking about the field and those big questions that we should be asking.